This content has been brought to you by my Patreons, and if you'd like to join them, link is in the description.
Welcome to Overthrow Media, your best place for politics, hip-hop, and life. It is Big Villainish, your comrade revolutionary, dope-ass MC, Nash Sex Symbol. Today, we're going to be talking about why it's hard to be a black anarchist.
Living in the house of Usher, parasitical at his structure. The plague begins to cluster in the house of Usher.
One of the reasons why it's so difficult to be a black anarchist is because you're consistently invisibilized by both your own community and by white folks. Despite the majority of anarchists not actually being Caucasian, but instead being multiple people of color from different backgrounds, historically from Latin America, to tell you the truth, which include Afro-Latin folks. When you hear about the protests, when we turn up and riot, or whatever the fuck happens, right? They try to play it off like it's white anarchists infiltrating the black communities. But that's not what's really happening. In fact, a lot of people turning up ain't even anarchists, but for what it is, we out there, right? Putting in for our movements. There's a list of black anarchists that you could actually dive into, but I'm gonna leave that to a comrade, St. Andrews, to explain, so go over and check out his video.
He realized the Panthers had stopped being a party concerned with the daily struggle of black people in America, and instead one totally focused on defending its membership in court trials against the state. Soon, he had embraced what he described as New African Anarchism. Quote, "Of all the ideologies, anarchy is the one that addresses liberty and equalitarian relations in a realistic and ultimate fashion. It is consistent with each individual having an opportunity to live a complete and total life. With anarchy, the society as a whole not only maintains itself at an equal expense to all, but progresses in a creative process unhindered by any class, caste, or party. This is because the goals of anarchy don't include replacing one ruling class with another, neither in the guise of a fairer boss, or as a party."
The consistent invisibilization of our people that are black anarchists is ridiculously high, because one thing they don't want to cross is the idea of black liberation and autonomy. Because when we start challenging those thought processes, then we may be able to truly get free. But because of how they portray anarchy is some chaos, which is not true at all. Like, nobody believes in chaos. Chaos ain't even a real concept. Chaos doesn't exist within this universe. Everything has some type of organization out here. But the way they betray it is used to try to alienate us from our communities, because anarchism is one of the most powerful weapons for liberation. The ideas of direct democracy and consensus is a real powerful direction that we could head as a black community. But because of our invisibilization, as if we do not exist, that we have no analysis or ability to interact with these concepts, it leaves us to be outliers in our own communities. Generally, they see us as troublemakers because they don't understand what we're really advocating. In fact, a lot of times it helps just not mention that you're an actual anarchist in a black community. But this is an artificially created tension, mainly created from the state, but also perpetuated by white anarchists, by the way they choose to navigate, specifically egoists, specifically nihilists who think more about the individual instead of the collective. Because one thing you'll learn quickly about black communities, at least those who are still in touch with our roots, we are very collective thinking. Now, there's some people who have sold out and want to Tom directions and feel like them getting currency is somehow liberation, and somehow something to be seen as high value. But in reality, it is not. Because we, as a people, generally try to think about our whole community. And the virus of individualism is put in there to divide us. So, what do you think about all that I'm talking about? Leave a comment down below. Let me know how you feeling about it. Also, hit that like button, subscribe, hit that bell so you can stay notified. Make sure to put it on all so you get every notification. And follow me on all my social media. That means villains underscore music at TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, SoundCloud, Twitch, and Patreon. Materialism put in there to divide us. And when I say materialism, I don't mean understanding that material reality is what all analysis should be based off of. I mean materialism as in capitalism. That's in that if you have two houses and a Lexus, you good. But usually you sort out your people to get there. But that's a topic for another video. For those who have chosen to call themselves leaders within our community, which usually just means someone who exploits resources to other black folks, we are a threat. Because we advocate that the people, the black community, decide their destiny. Don't look to these leaders, but look to each other to figure out how we're gonna find our own solutions. And so a lot of effort from both white folks in the state, as well as black leadership, goes into dividing us from our own communities. Another reason it's hard to be a black anarchist is being surrounded by non-black folks. Despite not being the white like people claim to be, there's a lot of brown folks and people who do not understand our struggle who are anarchists. People who often use microaggressions and sometimes blatant racism as a tactic, even when they're not white, even when they're people of color. In fact, sometimes it feels like it's more because white people feel like they need to walk on eggshells. But people of color that are brown, for example, a lot of times perpetuate anti-blackness within these movements, within anarchy. One of the things is that a lot of the culture doesn't mix, right? A lot of our backgrounds don't mix. The way we think and perceive situations don't mix. Because America's taught people to see us as the antithesis of failure, of what you don't want to be when you live inside this country, inside this continent, around these people. I won't lie though, I'm down with the smashy. One thing that really comes up quickly is the fact that we do not fit the aesthetic. Because we don't generally tend to want to lean towards or into punk rock, secondhand clothes, and having holes in our clothes. It's time for a word from the sponsor, right? If you want to support the content I'm putting out, make sure to cop some of this dope ass merch or support me on Patreon. Because one of the things is poverty was used as a way to oppress us consistently when we were growing up. A lot of us, at least. Some people didn't live those experiences, that's true, but when I speak, I generally speak about people who grew up in the hood. Fuck the bullshit. And we tend to not like so much punk rock as we like hip-hop, R&B, soul. We like to dress fresh and show that we have some value. Because if we dress fresh, then people will show respect for us and see us as human beings. But if we dress like we don't give no shits, like we can have holes in our clothes everywhere and nobody give two damns about it, then we find out really quickly that people will treat us like scum, even among anarchist ciphers a lot of times. Definitely without side. So we definitely don't fit that aesthetic. We tend to want to be a little more clean, a little more fresh, a little more likely to be seen with respect. And I'm not saying this is how the world should be, but this is how the world is. And this is how our experience is, and so we navigate specific ways that don't make us fit the aesthetic, so it makes it hard to be a black anarchist. One of the last reasons that really puts a divide and makes it hard to be a black anarchist, as we're seen as people who always make it difficult, because we always have issues that we have to address, and we also tend to address our issues directly. And because of that directness, it puts us at odds with a lot of people who would rather deal with it very subtly. Though I can get down with subtleties, I know that I'm not really with the subtle shit. I'm pretty bad with that, because I'd rather be direct and say exactly what the fuck I mean. And I think I value people who say what they mean. Don't move the goalposts and try to reevaluate what they said to make themselves look better. But instead, just run with what they feel. And if they need to get checked about it, we'll get checked. Sometimes people call me on my shit, and you know, sometimes I gotta be like, all right, you're right. And sometimes I'm like, nah, fuck it, I'm doubling down on that. Just depends on the situation. Depends on what they're saying. Depends on like what I'm seeing in that. But because of that, I'm seen as more difficult. Because I'm also able to resort to physical violence to solve an altercation that needs physical violence. It's also another reason that I'm seen as difficult. And it's not just me. I see that trend among all black folks that are anarchists, except for the few that choose to act more in an assimilated way. And so those situations tend to make it very difficult to be a black anarchist. Very difficult to walk this path of anarchy while chasing our liberation. But what the fuck else am I supposed to do? Become an authoritarian? Fall into the same trap that we fall into over and over again? That everything in history taught us is not the effective way. Nah, I'm good. but choose to be autonomous, but choose to shape my own destiny. It's by what many might think. So next time when you ask where the black anarchists, maybe look to black folks, black people, and see where we exist, because most of the time we will exist within our communities, not the anarchist scene. You feel me?
Walking through the crease and the cracks of the streets, struggling for some food and a bed to sleep, while trying to God's overthrow